Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show here on Urban TV. Now, in case you're joining us for the first time, this show airs weekdays on Thursdays at 10 p.m. here on Urban TV. Better still, you can watch the repeat on Saturdays at 8 in the morning and learn something about how you can improve your business. Okay, I keep saying if you are running a business and you're doing the ordinary, then don't expect the extraordinary. So sometimes as a business person, you need to sit back and ask yourself, what is that unique thing that I am doing that makes me stand out? If five lockups or five shops sell the same imported brand new shirts or shoes or trousers, you need to ask yourself, what is the guarantee that the person that walks in will choose my shop over any other shop? That's what we want to talk about this week on how to make money, because this is a story of a lady who not only looks at just making shoes, but now she has decided to go ahead and design them. She makes extra designs on the same shoe that you would find on the street. So she picks them and then she redesigns. This, she says, is meant to attract, you know, customers. But the most important reason she does this is to stand out, because innovation is the way to go. And if you want to win the next client with something new, then you might want to think about how you need to make it look different from the obvious. This is how to make money.
My name is Josephine Akafero, the CEO and creative designer of Jose House of Creations. We are a house of creations that makes a range of products, ranging from shoes, from clothes, cushions, furniture, upcycled puff seats, coasters, a range of products, because we do not only limit ourselves to clothes, like most businesses do when it comes to fashion. So that's why we say, we call ourselves just a house of creations. Imagine a house that is able to produce a range of things. So you just come through, you mention it, and we make it. I started this business some time back, though it wasn't my main source of income. It was my side gig, and I was into employment then, but I used to just find a little time to get into my passion, which is the fashion and design. And then I was not even doing most of the products that I am making right now. So fully, I ventured into my passion, which is this business, in 2017. That's when I quit employment and I went into entrepreneurship, a journey that has been a roller coaster, but worthy venturing into, because it has taught me a lot of things and it has made me the person I am today and everything I have achieved. I started it with not so much money, because I had not saved that much money. That's why I always tell people, whoever comes to me for advice when it comes to business and entrepreneurship, I always tell them, you don't need a lot of capital for you to start, because when you wait to save that money, you will waste all of it because you will not know how to use it. So start with a little, fall, get up, fall, get up. So it teaches you, the business itself will teach you the best lessons you need. Not even any universal institution or high institution of learning will teach you business and entrepreneurship practically, like the business itself. So I started with around 500,000, which I used to pay for the rent, only rent. So the rest of the things, I got most of the things from my house where I was staying to come and use it, to have a nice lounge for the business, for people to come through and be able to support me. And that's how I started my hustle. It wasn't easy, but I said, I have no return ticket. I am going all in for it. And here I am. I didn't start here. I was somewhere else, but today I am standing here. I love shoes, and I know in the era we are in today, people wear shoes. Gone are the days where people used to even move in sandals, sapatu as in sapatu sandals, or barefoot. So these days, as fashion has evolved, people wear shoes and they love comfort. So one of the main shoes that I normally use are All Stars, because they're comfortable and you can always wear them as casual shoes, or you can even wear them for a party depending on how you choose to match them with whatever that you're going to wear. So I decided to venture into the shoes, because people buy shoes, people love shoes, and it's one way that I could incorporate my passion, which is designing using an African print, normally, commonly known as a kitenge, that I can give it to people and they not only look at them as kitenge for clothes, because in Africa, most people think that kitenge is only to be worn as clothes. So I wanted to give people a variety of ways of being able to use a kitenge, not only in clothes. So that's where I specialized in African, or what we call Ankara shoes. We call them Ankara shoes, yes. In business and entrepreneurship, one of the things that I've learned, the moment you chase away a problem, you will not be able to prosper and grow. Every business has got its own challenges at all scaling. So in my business, I choose to look at challenges as opportunities, as much as I'm going to mention about them, but I don't want them to go away because they make me better every time they challenge me. So every time they challenge me, they teach me something. By the time I come out of that challenge, I'm a new person. That's one of the things, the principles of entrepreneurship that I've learned. Gone are the days where you see a problem and you're like, I wish God can take this problem away. So the moment God takes away that problem, that means you're not going to learn and you'll not get to the next level. So one of the challenges we had from the beginning was to make Ugandans and Africans at large that you can actually wear a kitenge shoe, or what we call Ankara shoes, because for them it was more or less just buying imported products and you wear, that's all. As much as most of our clients are expatriates and whites, they appreciate this work because it's creativity. So it wasn't easy to make a Ugandan or an African person, Ugandan in particular, that, you know what, buy this African, this Ankara shoe, and it is beautiful, it's unique, it's different. And the person would ask you, why are you selling it this much? That's a lot of money if I can access it on market at a cheaper price. But there is a difference between class and something ordinary. So if you want something different, something beautiful and unique, you have to invest in it. And that wasn't easy, but along the way, we were able to manage to convince them, just like for the car tires. People see car tires as, most especially when you're just removing it from your car, as waste. So you're just going to throw it away and it's done. So for me to be able to convince an ordinary Ugandan that, you know what, buy this product, it's made out of a car tire, it wasn't easy. Actually, it was one of the toughest things that I faced in business, but I kept going, I didn't give up. I said, I'm going to add value to this car tire, make it as a puff seat, make it as a coffee table, and make it as a chair for you to be able to use it. So those are some of the questions that I used to get. Why are you making me buy a car tire that much? Value addition is very important. That's why when you buy, let's say, I give an example of a cow. A cow can give you a variety of products. It can give you meat, it can give you milk, it can give you... So it depends on what you do to add value to that product that you get from a cow. By the time you add value to it, that means you're spending. So when you spend, that means the value, the cost of that product is not going to remain the same. It's the same thing with us when it comes to the products that we make. The moment we add value to what we're doing, it takes the price up. So it's upon someone to appreciate that level of creativity and hard work that we add into this for them to come and support and buy the products that we make at Joe's House Operations. And that's fulfilling. I'm so confident and proud and happy that we are able to do this. Not so many people do that. The other thing I would say, probably the taxes that are involved along the way, but still they're not going to go away. So we choose to embrace them and you see, how are we going to turn this around so that we keep going? Because every time you keep looking at a problem as a problem, it will stay there and you'll not go anywhere. Or you quit, but I'm not actually quitting, is not even anything that I look at in my life. The quality of what we produce is what makes our products quite costly. So if you're looking at something that is unique, beautiful, and classy, something that is not going to be everywhere. That's why you do not see many people doing what we do. There are many people into the fashion business, but you don't find any with all the range of products that Joe's House Operations makes. So that alone makes us stand out. So if we are able to give you something that you're not going to find everywhere on the street, that is already enough, that is worth you spending your money on the products that we make. Me, I feel the government can do better. As much as there are so many empowerment campaigns here and there that they are being carried out, but I don't think they are really that much satisfying to the young entrepreneurs. They are those well-established entrepreneurs. They were given incentives that has helped them. Even actually foreign investors are given many opportunities for them to invest in a country where they don't even charged. Let's say they are given free land, they are not spending any money to open up all those big, exactly, and then free taxes. If only can they actually provide such incentives to young entrepreneurs like us. We have the brains. We have the brains and we are very creative that we are making products that if only we are being supported well enough by our government, our economy would be way better compared to some other economy or to the years back. But the fact that we are not being facilitated that much, it limits our productivity. By now, you would even be seeing most of these products in different stores in France, in Europe, all over, in the US, because they are marketable products. Yes, but in 2019, I was in Paris. I was privileged to be taken to Paris by the French government. I tried to move around because as a creative, I wanted to acquire more knowledge to be able to come back home and use it and be able to make my work better. I moved to different stores, fashion creative stores, fashion related stores. I did not find any African product, I mean Ugandan to be specific, products being sold in these places. Not my products in particular, because by then I was not the person I am today, but any other creative or any other entrepreneur in Uganda. But I was able to find Kenyan products, surprisingly. And it was actually so disappointing that is how it felt like. How can Kenyan economy be that good that these countries take on their products and they sell them? And Uganda is nowhere. Uganda is a very rich country. If only we have better policies put in place and we are being supported, because it helps our country, it helps our economy. It's not just about me, Jose, as a person, but it's about our entire country, because when I succeed, my country succeeds. People are getting employment. Young people are motivated and inspired by Josephine as a person, but they have no idea what it takes to stand this brand as Joseph's Operations. If only, that's why when you see white countries, Western countries, they are being supported. When they see someone doing something through and they support them so that they push. It is not about the person in particular. It's about what this person is pushing forward to the interest of their government. And at the end of the day, they make it. Me, I would say, I always tell people, it doesn't have to be in millions of money for you to start. I started with my passion. I believed in my dream. Regardless of whatever we look at as challenges, I didn't stop. I will not say that it kept flowing, that it was a bed of roses. It was a roller coaster. It was full of the bumps, the highs, the lows. But I believed in myself. My passion kept pushing me and I didn't give up. So I would tell any young person out there, be determined with what you want. Be passionate about it, because when you do what you love, there is a saying that if you don't do what you love, you are wasting time. That even when you have a slight challenge, you will give up, because that's not what you love. You're just there because you're there for survival. So even if you start right now, you cannot say you're going to start a business and you want to have a very expensive a space for rent, because that's one of the challenges that people face when it comes to renting. You can even start from your home, grow your business. Right now, the platforms are there for you to advertise your business and people get to know them. You can have an online store. Gone are the days where you have to have a physical location for you to sell. If you have an online store and you're doing very good work, and even if you're selling from home, you can be able to make it. Like in these developed countries, it's not everyone that is actually having a store or a space, a physical location. But for as long as you have good work and you are able to deliver to the people, you are good to go. I am proud of my business because it has grown to where it is today, that I have this shop where I am, and I have a branch in Jinja, and I have another branch in Entebbe, and being able to employ other young people and passing on the knowledge, like training and mentoring other people into what I do. That's one of the things that I take much pleasure in and I don't take for granted. It's fulfilling on my side, because I know I am playing a big role to the country, that even after years when I'm no longer into this industry, someone will be able to proudly say, Jose contributed to what I am today.
Why do you think Ugandans do not appreciate products made in our country?
Because some of them have not given them a reason to. So every time, when I was starting out, I didn't know how to make people know, to appreciate this, until when I learned that if you give someone a reason to buy your product, they will give you the money. Then it wasn't easy, but right now an ordinary Ugandan spends that much money and buys this shoe, which wasn't easy then when I was starting out. because it was the same question, why are you making me pay that much money if I can go downtown and I get that All-Star at 25 or 30,000 or 50,000? But right now I gave them a reason to buy it. So I give you the worth of the money that you're spending. My last remarks to everyone watching, when you're doing what you're doing, don't give up, first of all. Don't look at challenges as challenges. Look at the challenges as opportunities for you to elevate and become better. Be passionate about what you're doing, and above all, put God at the midst of everything you do. You will succeed.
So regardless to say, her shoes that she makes actually look amazing. And at the end of the day, it's not just about winning customers. If the lady tells you that the pair of shoes that she's selling goes for 50K, for instance, and yet on the market they go for about 45, the first question would be, why would I buy the one of 50, yet there's only 45? But if you look at the designs that she's putting on the shoes, there's actually something unique about it, and it makes it even look better. So as a business person, every day you step out, try and do something that is new, that will make a customer think twice before spending their money on that product. Okay, let's then talk you through how to manage your personal finances this week.
Hello, Augustin Tamale, my name's still navigating in the tough times is what we are looking at, with a focus more on individuals, but businesses can also pick a leaf. Of course, for businesses you could consider hedging, agreeing on the foreign exchange contracts earlier on. You could sign a forex hedge of probably 3,850 shillings per US dollar, such that you are shielded. Even when it is 3,900, you have an agreement with the bank, they are still selling to you at the other agreement you've had. So businesses can also find a way of navigating. But as individuals, how many jobs are you doing? Are you doing only one job? Is there another one you can do in the evening? You see, when you read the book of Ecclesiastes, you can see that work in the morning and in the evening, don't let your hands rest. Sow a number of seeds, for you don't know which one will profit you. In a conversation with a young man who handles electrical matters, but is also a physics, mathematics teacher, he was concentrating on only the electrical matters to earn his income. And I told him, but you still have a qualification as a physics teacher. Can't you teach physics? And he looked around and got a school where he can teach early morning. They didn't have a physics teacher for their A-level. So early morning, 7 a.m. he's teaching physics, because they have now to adjust to his program since they don't have a teacher. So 7 a.m. he's teaching physics. 8 a.m. he's moving to his routine job. So that has added on to his income. So how many jobs are you doing? Abroad, people can do more than one job. In Uganda, we relax. You do a job and then in the evening at 5, you say, oh, I'm worn out, and you go and you relax. When you go abroad, you have to work hard. Otherwise, your liquidating of your assets to get that visa is useless when you don't earn something sensible. So people work hard, changing from one job to another. Can we get that culture while here at home? Can't we put in more? What else can you do after your work? Are you able to do something in a supermarket, in a retail outlet? Are you able to do something in a pharmacy? Probably you work that shift of 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Can't you dispense those drugs? Maybe you have that qualification in pharmacy, you have that diploma. Now you've spent the day working somewhere In the evening, you pass by a pharmacy and you are the one at the counter. Why can't you do that? It can help you to ably add up whatever you need to do, and then your income increases. But in the evening, you're on leisure, just either you are drinking something or you are watching a soccer match in the evening. These soccer matches, we can find later, they are replays. You can find them later. Can't you add on something extra to do? Or right in your home, if you are in the town, some urban farming of the sort, so that there's something you are doing in the evening. Don't just go home and sit. There should be some extra income. Are you an accountant? There are businessmen who don't know how to organize their books of accounts. Why don't you offer them that service? After work, your regular job, your day job, in the evening, you are preparing the books for some trader who doesn't know. So they give you their checkbook, they give you their bank statement, their receipt book and invoice book, and you start putting together their books. It will help you instead of just going home and you get into leisure. Do something extra so that your income increases. Let me say, this is a time of minimizing expenditure as well. In which school are your children? Isn't it time to change it if you can't afford it? Are you going to run crazy? Because again, borrowing for school fees is suicidal. It doesn't add to the inflow of money. I believe in borrowing for medical emergency, borrowing for investment. That's what I believe in. If you are borrowing to pay school fees, tuition for your children, that is suicidal. Children are not an income project. If it's a good school, you needed it. But these are tough times. Isn't there a moderate one to which you can change? This is a time to think through. Where are you renting? Isn't that apartment too expensive? It may be time for you to shift now and get into an apartment that's probably lower. What about your transport means? Have you evaluated them? Is it cheaper for you to use public means or to drive to work or to ride to work? Which one is cheaper for you? Look through and see the option that is going to work for you, so that the cost you have in order to get to your workplace or to your business premises can be adjusted downwards during these tough times. During these tough times, it's not a must to drive. And if at all two of you are driving, why can't you move early and you use one vehicle? Why should the two of you drive? Think through these things and be able to reduce on your expenditure. That is very, very key for you to reduce on your expenditure. What about the type of work you are doing? Is that the only thing you can do? Maybe you need now to change. This may not be the only thing you can do in life. Probably it's time for you to change vocation and do something else that can earn you some sufficient amount of money, or something that you can do nearer to home such that you minimize on transport.
To the Forex market and the social security exchange markets as well, there has been a bit of a movement by different listed companies, and the shilling against the dollar has been about 3.484 or thereabout, depending on where you're transacting from. Let's now have a look at the comprehensive report on the Forex and money markets. So I'm not very sure of what you watch on TV, but if you want to catch all the programs that are edutainment or will help you learn as you laugh, then you have no reason to switch after this show. There's a lot more coming up on Urban TV that need to catch up on. Better still, you can get through our papers, The New Vision, and see the latest stories making headlines in the world of business. My name is Simon, and that's all we have time for on The Business Show this week. Thank you so much for making time. Feel free to get in touch with us or get back to us. Tell us where you're watching from. Or better still, how is your business faring? I've seen conversations and people saying times are not the best. There's less money for people to spend. And so the sales are not as much. And then on the contrary, you find guys who are saying, actually, they are making sales. So at the end of the day, it's about how you position yourself in the market. If you're going to sit back and wait for people to come through you, then you might want to think twice, because times are changing and people are on the move. Can you go digital? Can you advertise online? Can you offer the delivery channels? Can you make things easier than it should be for the buyer? From the team and myself, it's a wrap. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.